and welcome back to the 4am report. If you've just found us on this is the third in an episode arc about the types of episode formats that you can employ within podcasting, especially if podcasting is on your mandate for 2022 and you're trying to put together a plan. This is worth listening to. If you haven't heard the first two episodes, which talk about teaching podcasts and show and tell types of podcasts, go back and take a listen to those before you listen to this one. I would argue that this method of podcasting probably will come in once you have done podcasting for a few months and are able to take stock of your comfort with the medium. So the third type of podcast episode, that is the challenger to the hero's journey, like death to the hero's journey. What is the third type? I like to call it the fast and efficient type. Sometimes it's fast, sometimes it's efficiency that motivates it. And what I mean, what falls under that particular kind of podcast episode category is newsjacking episodes. Like if you're an agency, if you are a financial organization, legal organization, any one of those things, and you have the ability to quickly respond to news, that's fantastic. And, you know, those type of episodes always do way better than episodes that are storytelling. So that's worth considering. The other thing to think about is the efficiency side of it, which is that the average evolved organization has content in different formats. And you really want to be looking into your hiding Zoom calls, you know, internal meetings and things like that to see whether some of that is usable again, which you can repurpose and put into your podcast with a preamble or similar, right? And so those serve the purpose of being able to get you back some bandwidth by putting less work on your team to get an episode out. So consider those, consider the fast and efficient route as a third. Remember, it's important to decide on a level of editorialization when you're repurposing. Repurposing doesn't mean just throwing something out over and over again, getting the link out there and distributing via social. That's one way of distributing. That's distribution, not repurposing. Repurposing is when you take some material and you sort of break it up or reimagine it in multiple ways so more people will consume it. And for that, I think the key thing to think about is editorializing. You really want to be deciding what you want to add to it. So as an example, I have pulled together a number of clips that deal with this subject, but the way it is in our current calendar might not be giving you this information back to back in this format. So I've put a new preamble and curated those clips. So you really do need to decide what level of editorialization is required. Now, you will find here a series of clips where we've broken down the types of episodes with some examples. Enjoy.
Welcome to the 4am Report. On this podcast, we dish about fresh pressed, fun marketing. If you're stressed out and awake at night again, wondering what to do, you found your joy. I'm your host, Susan Diaz, podcasting founder, humor junkie, observer of human behavior patterns, and mom. Each week, I'm joined by a different co-host to break down the latest headlines at the intersection of marketing and entertainment.
Something we have really used a lot, or that we, you know, enjoy doing, I would say, is newsjacking episodes. Every week we do something called Thirsty Thursday, where we do a roundup of the hits and misses in the world of marketing, pop culture, entertainment, you know, social injustice, everything. We kind of pick our top 5 to 7 favorite stories and we chat them out. That goes out on video, but then we also do release that as an extra podcast episode. And the one thing about, if you do decide to comment on the news of the day, you have to be ready to turn that episode around as quickly as possible, because with the news cycle these days, what was new and interesting today, everyone's sick of hearing about in 2 days. So you got to be able to be really agile and quick on that. So that's one of the struggles with it. But also one of the benefits of the newsjacking episode is you get to hashtag Free Britney. You get to hashtag the Olympics. You get to jump on those topics that people are searching for. And, you know, I know on Instagram, those are the episodes we do get a lot of extra traffic because people are looking up Free Britney. And then, of course, we spoke about Free Britney last week. So, yeah.
Right. That's so true. 100%. You have to turn it around fast. I'd say as fast as like a day or two. And I know the reason that we're highlighting that is because sometimes we'll go on podcasts together, Will, or I'll go on my own. And the release of that thing is so much after when you record it, you're like, oh my God, I should really remember not to say anything that's time bound and stuff like that. Right. Mm-hmm. So really think about what is your production cycle before you lean into this. We obviously, we're marketers and we can show off about this kind of thing. So we have the ability to turn it around fast. And so it's a really viable option. So, and I know the another industry that does this well is the financial industry, although they have a lot of compliance and that gets slowed down, but like they have internal teams that are able to quickly comment, like you're able to jump on the news and talk about something, right? So that's kind of what you want to be thinking about. The next batch of like the next four types from like the ninth type onwards, variations on the sort of repurposing theme, right? Well, like we often, like we said, once you have a significant volume of episodes, and let's define that at like 25. At 25, you'll already see some opportunities to start repurposing your episodes. When I say repurpose, I mean beyond the distribution where you're splitting it up into videos and you're, you know, splitting it up into text. The first thing you want to think about is like, perhaps have you done 3 episodes about mental health, or have you done, in our case, like 10 episodes about podcasting? Is there something in there that you can combine? Could you pull out highlights from all 10 of them and then provide like a thing? So really starting to look at repurposing and clustering together. Like you want to think of clusters of episodes, bringing them together. Maybe 2 people spoke about workplace. In our case, remember 2 people spoke about Colby. We talked about teams and how, yes, you know, yes, Colby is sort of the love language of teams. And we had somebody who was a Colby trainer and then somebody who uses Colby. And then we put both of those together for people who were really thinking about like, how do we get the right fit and match and that sort of thing on teams.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And the thing about repurposing too, it can be as easy or as involved as you want it to be. So sometimes we will just say, here's 3 episodes on crisis communications that work really well. And we'll just edit all 3 episodes together into a monster episode. Sometimes we'll want to go in and do a new fresh introduction, a preamble, as we like to call it, setting up that we're looking back at 3 episodes on this one topic from the past, and we've only chosen little bits from each one and we've edited them together. Some people like to be even more intense, do a preamble, just go into a specific area, then go back to them in another kind of mini preamble, go into another one. It just all depends on what you prefer. And I would say, again, to make it easy on yourself, the less tinkering, the better. But, you know, if you're a tinkerer, have fun.
Yeah. I think 100% that editorializing, you have to pick what level of editorializing you want to do with it, and then keep it simple. So think about, you know, like the 10th format, like we said, Will, was maybe, you know, the best of. Like sometimes we've done, top 5, right? These are the top, like we did one at the end of last year, or no, after 100 episodes, we did our top 5. That tells you something. So that kind of thing is, again, a lower effort sort of thing. Then the 11th format is what Will described, which is repurposing the long form audio into video. That's like a really important one. So we do Thirsty Thursday. And for the longest time, we kept them completely separate because the audiences were different. It was whatever, we wanted to test it. But now the Thirsty Thursday sound plus a bonus story for those who are listening to podcasts comes in as we talked about. And then the final format, and maybe you can chat this out a little bit, Will, is the repurposing of the mastermind or your live event or your Zoom recordings of different types.
Yeah. Oh, for sure. For sure. And I think a lot of people are seeing the efficiency of doing this, the benefit of doing this. So, you know, for instance, we have a client, she does these bootcamp live events where she'll be on camera talking to everyone who signed up virtually. Well, we now take sections of those live videos and just rip the audio, and they work perfectly well as a podcast. Also, going into knowing that you're going to do this as a podcast, you literally could say to the people at your mastermind, or, you know, at your whatever webinar, the whatever you're doing, virtual, and be like,
well,
and by the way, everybody, this is also going to be an episode of my podcast. Like making them feel involved in the fact that it's going to be one of your podcasts too is cool as well. And it's going to invite them to go back and listen to that podcast when it comes out. But looking at those virtual events when you're recording yourself anyways, and approaching it and knowing it that, oh, I'm aware that this also will be pulled as a podcast. You've got like, it's just so mind-blowingly efficient to me.
It is. And that makes me talk about a mindset aspect to this, Will, which is that when it comes to repurposing, you really have to look at it and be okay with the fact that, ooh, is it that easy? It can't be that easy. Well, sometimes it can and it should, mm-hmm. because that's the only way that you're going to flywheel, right? Like what is a flywheel? A flywheel is when you, it takes a lot of effort to do something at first and then it gets simpler. So same amount of input, either more output or something has to, like the volume has to keep changing. And I think that's really important, is to tell yourself, it's okay. Like, it's okay. Only I am bored with this. Nobody else is bored with this because they haven't heard it. So,
And you know, don't you feel like a proud mama when one of our clients is like, oh, Susan, oh, Will, I just did an event and I actually recorded it. And I think we should turn it into a podcast. We're like, yes, let's do that.
Our work is done.
I know, right? Fly away, little baby bird.
Thank you for listening to the 4AM Report. If you like what you're hearing, we'd love if you left us a 5-star review. Thank you.